Hello, and welcome to The Base, Big and Small Screens. This week we're back, and I'd like to talk to you about Memento. That's right, Memento. Now, this is a movie that has a bit of a polarizing opinion, I think. Stars Guy Pearce, Carrie Ann Moss, and Joe Pantoliano. Guy Pearce is playing Leonard Shelby. He is he's a guy whose wife was attacked, basically. Someone attacked her and him in their home, brutally beat, raped, and murdered his wife. He ended up with severe brain damage due to the beating he took and is unable to form short-term memories. He just forgets after a little while. Everything just kind of fades away from him. He can remember everything prior to the attack just fine. Afterwards, very, very difficult to keep it. So he starts using photographs and notes, and even tattoos on his body to remind him of things, to keep him going. And he's on a mission for revenge for the ones. So he spends, pretty much the entire movie is spent tracking down the ones that were responsible for it and putting an end to them. So, what then? Why is this such a polarizing movie? Well, it has to deal with how it was filmed and how it was presented, because it's not presented in chronological order. They actually have the ability on the DVD to watch it in chronological order if you want. There is that option. But the original theatrical way it was presented was all out of order. You'd start with a certain particular point and it would be going on from that point, and then jump back in time or jump forward in time, and it would go bouncing around the plot line. Certain scenes were not in color, which let you know it was kind of in the future, maybe, or possibly in the past. A very confusing and bizarre movie. But I liked it for what it portrayed, how it portrayed the ability to remember things as being very integral to being able to live a life, because the guy in here is not someone that you should be vindicating. It's someone you should be pitying for what happened to his life. And yeah, it is seriously strange and unusual in how everything is set up and everything. Guy Pearce does an amazing job in it. Carrie Ann Moss, you may remember her from The Matrix, I believe. Possibly, I'm not sure. Joe Pantoliano is from The Matrix, however, and quite a few other movies. He plays a corrupt cop helping our young Leonard Shelby here find his revenge by tracking down certain people that may have clues or may have been involved in the home invasion. So yeah, it's definitely interesting. Now, personally, if you want to go and watch it in chronological order, be my guest. I'm not going to say anything about it. That's your choice. If you find it more easy to understand that way. But personally, I enjoyed watching it the original way it was intended, all broken up and strange and bizarre, because it's that sense of disjointedness that is coming across quite a bit that really puts you kind of in the mindset of Guy Pearce's character here, Mr. Shelby, and how he is and how he feels, because nothing ever really makes sense. There's the context of everything is all out of whack for him, and that gets portrayed through the way the movie is cut to you, the audience, and I do like that. So this week I think you should check out Memento, but that's just my opinion. You may have differing ones. But as always, my friends, if you like what I'm doing here, please give that like button a tap and give that subscribe button a tap as well if you haven't already, so you can be kept apprised of when I do new videos, usually trying to get one or two out a week, more if possible. And throw a comment in the comment section. Have you seen Memento? Did you like it? Did you hate it? Let's get a discussion going on that. And let me know if there's any other movies like Memento in a similar vein that you think I should be checking out. Please do. I'd love to hear from some people. So until next time, my friends, check out Memento. It's well worth your time. And I will see you next time.